environment and cities and spatial planning. It was really interesting, innovative for me. We were very productive group, in my opinion. Also, our mentor looked with good surprise in the papers and told us very good ideas, that's not only compliment. That's the reality, I hope. Then hope everybody of us knows that the environment in cities important for everybody. We try to. I'm not ready to detailize everything we did, but really hope that we'll help to contribution towards finishing of your smart city guide.
Yeah.
Thank you.
The vision quite intensively, and we had not so much time left for decision and commit, and we also found that some topics were really on the city part, and we had only one representative of the city, so that's why we concentrated on some the things we could do as a group, that were the financial schemes and how to set up the local ecosystem with whom. Who can I give the floor? Yeah, group number two. That's Georgi's group.
Yeah, thank you. We also worked quite actively on the vision. Yeah? And we, I think, as almost everyone here, combined vision, decision, and commit in one paper here. We realized that there is a huge gap on the district heating in the city of Sofia, and on the pricing policy of it, and not only on the pricing policy, but the entire also management concept also for the infrastructure of the urban district heating. And we realized that there should be some more innovative models for the ESCOs, to see such models and to see how ESCOs become more benefit oriented and not just deal as municipal companies, talking not only about the Sofia district heating company. And we have on the topic of legislation, we decided that it would be good to have an interdependence between the construction price and the quality regulations, and also the insurance for planning and construction should be more person-oriented and not just company-oriented, because it's crucial for the success of the entire process. I'm talking all the time about energy efficiency and smart buildings at our group. Then, in the planning, plan and do, we are setting the following milestones, for example, work and information flow process, automation, then also a coordination between the national government and the local government on the e-government topic. Then the topic of solar water and solar heating as a part of the policy of the energy ministry should be emphasized. And then talking about the reconnection to the stakeholders, we are thinking on creating such a unit responsible for smart city, and particular on energy efficiency in the city, as for example we saw the example from Munich today, but also many other cities. And then Also very important, thinking on ESCO HR development and update. Extremely crucial topic for many cities, not only Sofia in Bulgaria. And then also talking about the coordination of the policy and the funding framework on the state-city relations on funding and on entrepreneurship. And also talking about state and city being not just an investor, but being an entrepreneur regarding the energy providing, the energy provision. Yeah. And then, when we're talking about KPIs, we defined the need of an entire toolkit for KPIs. When we're talking about energy efficiency and smart buildings, of course, it's logical that we're talking about primary energy reduction and CO2 reduction and PM2.5 reduction. But we are also talking about measuring via questionnaire the subjective improvements for the citizens, like comfort level improvement and so on. And then we are talking about concluding it by telling that what's the output. So the output for us is that we need the design and construction process quality guidelines, which can flow into national and city standards on this process we are talking about, and then also creating pilots for good practices, so we can raise the awareness of the citizens on what we are talking about and what we are doing regarding energy efficiency. And then, at the end, we concluded that we need the definition of some urban renewal and energy efficiency improvement areas for the city. So we are interrelating strongly with the urban planning. And then the coordination of the entire process should be overtaken by the city company for urban smart development or energy efficiency or however it's called and whatever it's in charge of. And we defined that we need to have annual assessment meetings of the smart city company on the energy efficiency and also energy bill check after the retrofit process is finished. This check should be done by this municipal company in order just to help the owners, to help the citizens to understand if they really achieved their goals or not, and if not, what to change. Probably it's their user behavior we're talking about. And we're talking a lot about big data, because in energy efficiency and smart buildings, big data plays a crucial role. So there should be a definition on municipal and probably national level as a standard for this big data for energy efficiency in order to be able to monitor in a proper way the results of the retrofit and optimization process. So I think that's all from us.
We're group number three about Sofia as ICT platform. We got to the point of planning, and we were really focusing on developing certain initiatives and projects. But in the beginning, we decided to actually defined three areas for development: open administration based on open innovation, automatization of our processes, and integration. And when we say integration, we mean in social, economical, and technical ecosystem level. We identify stakeholders as we have mobile operators on our table, and ICT firms, and a very important target group that is missed in the process is the new generation of alpha. Generation is called the youngest kids, basically. So we think they should be involved from the very beginning. to better understand their needs and the particular projects that we finally developed in the process, because it was really a broad discussion in the beginning with few arguments, pros and cons identified by the different people on the table. We had business representatives, we had a financial expert and a non-profit organization, so different points of view. But in the end, we came up with the first proposition to focus on the management and development of integrated transport and implementation of autonomous public transport vehicles. Also the so-called smart, sorry, it's very hard to translate now, but the
smart container.
Smart wasting container, wasting container.
Okay, smart waste management, thank you. And then smart parking and pollution control. Smart driving goes in the part of autonomous vehicles. And we propose to develop a consortium including financial institutions, NGOs, and mobile operators, developing the business model of combination of financial instruments, private financing from one side, and public grants from another. Also, another suggestion, like a mini initiative or bigger project actually, is the services, e-services developed by the municipality, which are entirely digitalized up to level number 4, meaning also covering the payment. And a very important point is the trans-border nature of all services. So if you live at one place, you want to do transactions or some kind of services to use in another country, let's say, to be able to do so. Somewhere in the discussion, there was a suggestion to use the chatbot as a tool by the municipality to communicate and open information to the citizens, and artificial intelligence in broader aspect to be implemented in many areas. So more or less, this is from our side.
Hello. In 5 minutes, I'll present you the outcomes of our group. We're group number 4. We focused on mobility problems. Basically, we identified 6 groups of problems. One is, of course, environment. The second one is safety of traffic. Third one is efficiency of driving, efficiency of traffic. The fourth one is traffic control. The fifth one is city planning in favor or against traffic. And the last one is, maybe a tool for resolving all the problems. This is a new decisions for urban mobility. So basically, we identified solutions for each of those 6 problems. I will not read all of them. You will probably take notice of them when we have the flip charts with you. And finally, we identified several KPIs, key indicators, which could be used to monitor how we resolve the problems. So basically, in terms of environment, what we see is PM10 or PM2.5 from tires, however. Not so much from gas emissions, which is the second issue. For the safety, the second problem, we see traffic incidents as a majority issue, and what we need to see, how they come, what happens before the traffic incident for it to take place. Then we see the lighting system and the traffic control system as an issue. In terms of efficiency, we see one person in one car, which is an issue with use of vehicles. Also, some people use cars maybe 2 out of 3 hours a day, which is a huge loss of time.
then we see the modality between the different modes of transport as an issue which is not applied. In terms of traffic control, the fourth problem, we see the wrongdoings in the crossroad systems. The traffic management is not used to make forecasts in order to see how traffic flows should go, and we don't see any solutions for the traffic jams. The cleaning of roads in winter is also an issue, especially in Sofia. The fifth problem, city planning, we see many new buildings in areas which don't have sufficient room for roads. We see many people preferring to live in the center, but there is not sufficient parking places. And finally, our Turkish colleagues suggested mobility as a service, which is here a problem because there is not a solution for it. So, those are the five problems. Solutions are market analysis of current and future traffic, load networks in order to improve transport planning. The second solution is needs analysis to upgrade the public city transport to make the interconnection between trams, buses, metro, automatic vehicle location system, automatic ticketing system, which is already being installed in Sofia. Then our Turkish colleague again suggested the BOT model, built operate transfer, to be introduced for major transport projects. Better information system for traffic jams and transport modes, how to reach a location within a specific time frame. In-city lights, sensors for traffic control, so there are many solutions. One of the sexiest ideas was for the future, especially when drones become much more popular in transporting goods and people. This is an issue which we have to see in the next up to 10 years. What will happen when air cars or air traffic systems are becoming more and more popular. The KPIs are a lot. And again, as mentioned before, we need to identify a system from a number of indicators. So we need to establish composite indicators based on names which I don't know, but Deming indicators. Okay. Do I say it correctly? Okay. And all the indicators for the movement of the population, one of our professors said that they are over 160. So maybe this should be another issue of discussion. How out of those 160 traffic control indicators to be selected the most promising ones? Other indicators like kilometers transport network per inhabitant or 45 minutes transport accessibility by different means of transport, how this is achieved within Sofia. So that's on our side. Thanks a lot for your attention.
Yeah, thank you so much, all the people here and all the groups. I think you all worked very hard. And even though we did not do, I think your group did most of the stages. Our group didn't do all the stages, so you could see different patterns. So it's good to see the differences. What I will do is I will take responsibility for wrapping it all up in the document. That's what we agreed with the SmarterTogether project and with the city, also in the SmarterTogether project, and also with the knowledge cluster, of course. But I also had a short chat with Dimitra and Milena, that it would be good to maybe continue this work with interested people in the future, because this was nearly only, I think, going with the toe in the hot water, but not yet a full bath. I think there are still many things to do for an integrated plan in Sofia. There are many things happening, but I think especially in this city, integrated perspective, holistic perspective can mean a lot. So I think we should come back to the people who are here today and ask them if they would be interested to further develop this idea and also give us feedback on if this method works. So that's also, if you have specific recommendations, please let me know, because we will improve the guidance package in the coming weeks, and it will be published somewhere in February, March, And the idea is to do that with a lounge in the European Parliament or in the House of Norway. And we would also like to see some representatives of City of Sofia then here, because the city has a, and the knowledge cluster, of course, have hosted this event and made it possible. So many thanks for that. And we hope to give some visibility back to you in return. So we will wrap it up, try to summarize it, try to align the ideas a bit. We cannot do it literally, because then it will be a lot of information, but we'll do it to our best knowledge. And you are very much welcome in the event we will organize then in February or in March in Brussels. Anything more I should say? Project ideas, yeah? Georgi wants to add something.
Okay, so first of all, thank you for all the very nice results. And second of all, I just wanted to assume once again that, of course, it was very important to validate and to give you lessons learned for the strategy, for the integrated planning strategy. But on the other side, of course, it was not just a simple military exercise what we did. But of course, we are trying to identify topics for further common work on several particular, also partially identified programs. And it would be very nice to keep on track and.
We lost you.
I'm still here, to keep on track and to work out these contents on the topics of mobility and. Urban planning, building planning, and entrepreneurship, for example, in a bundled shape in a bigger project very soon. So it would be fine to unite forces and do that. Thank you.
Okay, just a few remarks from our side. Thank you very much for all of you who actively participated today. And to our speakers, thank you very much for coming and sharing all your experience and knowledge with us. And to our participants, again, to the survivors, to the very last minute. I hope we'll see you again very soon on our next event. And as many people asked me about the presentations, we will discuss this, and also the speakers would like to share, they will be uploaded on the website of our cluster, and any other information will be there, so you will be updated on meetups, and of course you can get in touch with us at any point. Thank you once again, and have a nice evening.